In this podcast, I'm going to talk to you about marketing 101 for fitness coaches and online coaches looking to scale and blow up your business. Before we begin, my name is Charlie Johnson. We run seven-figure scaling systems. We help online fitness coaches blow up their business within 60 to 90 days. Now to get into it. So with marketing 101 for fitness coaches, one of the huge mistakes I see, and I'm going to start with this, is I remember when I was getting into the game, and if you listen to the first episode of this podcast, which I hope you have, about my story, one of the key things that I used to do was document my journey. But I took it too far. I was taking like ab selfies all the time. And I remember my mentor at the time being like, you come across as a narcissistic prick in your content. I was like, cheers. But that was always something that really stuck in my head. So you really don't want to be doing that in terms of the way you come across. You want to be trying to think about, okay, how can I develop strong connections with my audience and really think like, okay, this is something like that I'm going to inspire them with and something they're going to look up to in terms of like what they're looking to achieve and things like that. So with the type of content you want to be putting out, one of my favorite sayings to explain this is thinking about making content that's educational with utility. Now, with this, where do you want to be putting it? What platforms, you may well be asking. Well, different platforms are different. So Instagram, for example, we'd recommend you want to be doing that on like Reels. You can do it in your stories. Stories are always really good for selling in terms of call to actions as well. Facebook is exactly the same, main feed, same approach on stories. TikTok, generally humor stuff tends to work better. And then if you look at something like LinkedIn, which we have a lot of our clients crush it with, and this is one of the key things we teach within seven-figure scaling systems, which statistically, actually being a business coach who actually has an online fitness business, we teach is this. We make 2.5 times as much per lead from LinkedIn versus Instagram. So if you're not using that right now and you're stuck, feel free to message me Scale on Seven Figure Systems IG to find out how we can help you. But the key thing with this is understanding different platforms have different type of content. So LinkedIn, for example, you need to be using long form captions talking about that audience specific pain points with images. People on LinkedIn generally aren't watching videos because they tend to be at work most of the time. So they can read stuff but not be able to listen to things with the audio on. So an important thing to do is understand the difference of those platforms. Now, when it comes down to what platform is best to you, it's going to come down to what platforms you already have, what your audiences are, and who you're trying to target. So I often say this to guys when we consult, and girls when we're consulting with them at Seven Figure Scaling Systems, okay, who do you want to work with? Okay, I want to work with CEOs and executives who are 45, 50 plus. I was like, okay, cool. Like, what platforms are you using? Instagram. I was like, okay, and TikTok. I was like, okay. How many like CEOs and executives are on Instagram? Okay, yeah, there are some, granted, but the majority aren't gonna be pissing around on Instagram all day following fitness trainers. That's the reality. Whereas if you go onto a platform like LinkedIn, that's probably where you're gonna be hanging out. So this is one of the very key fundamental things you have to think about is where is the audience you're trying to target? What platform they're on? What countries they're in? What type of messaging resonates with them, which we'll come on to a little bit. Second thing in terms of from a marketing point of view to blow up your business in 2023, we wanna think about is, okay, and I mentioned this before, one of the previous podcast episodes, is like, who's your dream 100? Who are the people who have the audience you want? Those are the people you need to get in there, network with, they're the people you need to collaborate with, and they're the people who are gonna be like the gatekeepers to unlock the lead flow for you. And this is really what you need to do, is to get in front of these people, get with these people, and get seen with these people. Another huge power of this, and you wanna think about with your fitness business, is you wanna be the attractive character at the front of the business. You also wanna be leading by example, but you also wanna try and create celebrity status. So for example, if you're a fitness trainer, you want to start trying to get hanging around or being seen with people who are very high up in terms of the fitness industry. Like if, for example, you would go and train with The Rock and you put that on social media, do you think that would make you look high status and that you were going to probably get some leads from that? I would probably say so. So one of the keyest things you can do is try and create celebrity status, which is by training around other people with big followings, being involved in those things and trying to bring up your status. That's a key thing. Now, how to practically go about this? I would say the easiest thing is to try and talk to people in person if you see them. If you're in Dubai, this is generally pretty easy because most of them come here quite a lot. Or you can try and slide in their DMs and Instagram, which I would probably say is not very effective and doesn't really work because they get approached all the time. And like I do quite a lot as well. One of the things I'd say is you need, again, I like the term gatekeeper. So you need someone who knows them who can introduce you. So this is actually one of the things I do within our masterminds, also like connecting the dots of people with big followings so they can help people grow their audiences. And that's actually what one of my mentors is currently doing for me in terms of from the business realm, is he's opening the doors to me in terms of access to people that I want to learn from, or I want to be around, or I want to be within their audience. And that's one of the keys to help you grow in terms of marketing this year. Thirdly, next we're going to talk about paid advertising. Now, this we do phenomenally well with, but this is not something you need to be doing until you're probably doing 20, 30K a month. You should be able to do that easily from organic traffic alone. Now, when we talk about paid advertising, we've got a couple of different platforms. We've got Instagram and Facebook, you've got LinkedIn, you can also do TikTok, and you can do YouTube. The best one I predominantly recommend fitness trainers start with is going to be Facebook and Instagram, predominantly messenger ads. Messenger ads work best because what you can do is you can get people to message you, get them into a conversation, and warm them up. What tends to struggle the most, in particular if you're selling more expensive coaching, is doing ads which are going to send people directly to a like a book a call link. You'll find that they have a very poor conversion rate and not going to be the best reads. The only exception to this would be like retargeting ads. So if someone's like a warm lead, so like by retargeting and someone being warm is someone who follows you, engages with your content, something like that. The problem you have with this is warm retargeting leads are not, it's a small audience because you only got so many people who know you are. How you can kill and crush and scale your fitness business is when you can blast ads out into the cold traffic of people who haven't got a fucking clue who you are and you get them to convert. That's when you've got a business that can scale. And that's one of the key things we've done with CG Coaching. And I actually did a training on this last week in the Mastermind, which is on the portal for everyone there to watch. And this comes down to knowing your offer, your audience, your pricing, who you're trying to target, and actually understanding how the ads work. Now, a huge mistake I see a lot of people making is they try and outsource paid advertising. From experience, I've tried this 3 times. I have never seen anyone outsource paid advertising and get it to work with an agency. And do you want to know why? Why, if I was the ads guy running your ads for you, would I get you to pay me $2,500 a month to fucking around and pay, do all your ads for you if I was that good? If I was really good at ads, I would just create an offer to like sell the shake or whatever, for example, run it on paid traffic and make tons of money. So the reality is if someone who's really, really good, they would just do their own business and sell their own stuff on ads rather than having running ads for other people because that's a bit of a ball ache. So this is how you need to change your mind. The other thing I want to talk about in terms of paid advertising is also email marketing. So email is a powerful tool. However, for fitness coaching, I would say it's slightly overrated depending on who you are. So one of my great friends and who we have on the podcast as well, and he teaches in the Mastermind, Frank Den Blanken, has an email list of 4 million. He does very well with email marketing. He has a lot of people. He's in the Netherlands, which is a different niche. And reality with that as well is that he got all those email leads with paid ads, I think like 5-6 years ago when they were much cheaper. The reality is the cost of advertising has gone up. The cost of advertising will keep going up every year and that's never gonna end. So when you think about email marketing, yes, it's important, but this isn't the key thing you need to be focusing on to get to 10, 20K a month. It's not the key thing you need to be getting to 30K a month. Like in terms of our business that does multiple six figures a month, we do 5 to 7% of our revenue maybe from email. We have an email list of 100,000 to give you some context. One of the big red herrings I see is when people are getting advice to go down like setting up email marketing as the main lead generation strategy, one of the key things they need to focus on when there's so many other hanging fruit. So don't get dragged into this BS thinking this is gonna change the game for you. Now, last thing I'll talk about is for you in terms of marketing point of view, is literally sit, think, and think, okay, who is the customer I have and what pain points they have? Now, if you haven't watched the YouTube video I've done this already, check out ChatGPT. I did a full YouTube video explaining this and I did a training a mastermind on this. You can actually put into ChatGPT, which is artificial intelligence. What are the top 10 pain points that busy executives have who are male, who live in New York, who are 35? And it will give you all the pain points. And there you go. There's your ideas in terms of the content, the marketing you need to use in 2023 to speak to those people, get them to convert and get them to join your program so you can help them and ultimately you can have more impact and income. If this podcast episode was helpful, make sure you leave us a 5-star review, subscribe to the podcast. If you're watching on YouTube, drop us any comments below and make sure you head over and check out our IG, which is at 7 Figure Scaling Systems. If you want help scaling your business, also drop us a message on there with the word scale.